Everyone, welcome once again to this online physics class for standard 9. You all know that we have completed learning this chapter, that is chapter number 10, gravitation, and we have solved the sums given under the exercise part of your textbook. Under this chapter we have solved whatever is included in your syllabus. Those topics we have covered up. I have many times told you about the exempted portion from this chapter. What are they? Archimedes principle, buoyancy, relative density, thrust and pressure, these things are all omitted. Okay, so based on whatever you have, that is capital G, small g, importance of capital G, those things, whatever sums are given, I have solved all the sums. Okay, and now after your Diwali holidays, you know, in the month of December, somewhere around that, you'll be having your second periodic test, right? And this is the only chapter in physics you're going to have for second periodic test. So think about the time that is left in your hand. So just only one lesson is there. You have ample time. Please keep reading your textbook again and again. Play the videos pertaining to this chapter. Try to understand the concept. And sums are all very easy. It is solved in a very easy way and shown. Okay, please have a look at them and start preparing. Do not waste time. Whenever you know, you have to work on it, your time, how to manage that. And nothing is confusing. Whenever you feel it's confusing, please play the videos again and again and see. And apart from this, you have many other reference videos also in YouTube. You'll be getting it. Please, you can have a look at it even. Okay, so thorough understanding is more important rather than marking up. Okay, so shortly the notes will reach you. So start preparing yourself. So in today's session, we'll discuss some important points about your acceleration due to gravity, because there is a question based on this in your textbook. I'll be showing the question towards the end of this session. So based to solve that question, you need to understand all these basic points. So let's now see what's that. See, we know that the value of G near the surface of the Earth is 9.8 meter per second square. See, what is the formula for small g? Small g is equal to capital G into M upon R square, where capital G stands for universal gravitational constant and capital M stands for mass of the Earth and R stands for radius of the Earth. When you substitute all these standard values, that is your gravitational constant's value, mass of the Earth's value and radius of the Earth value, you get the value of small g near the surface of the Earth as 9.8 meter per second square. I've shown this also. How do we get this 9.8 meter per second square in my previous videos? Please watch that again. Okay, now see, you all know what is acceleration due to gravity. So this acceleration due to gravity is always directed vertically downwards, right? So it's talking about the acceleration shown by the object falling towards the surface of the Earth, that is towards the center of the Earth. Okay, now see, whenever you throw an object in the upward direction, what about its motion? In which direction does it move? It always moves in the opposite direction of gravity. When you are throwing the object upwards, remember, when the object is coming downwards, it is coming down due to the force of gravity. Earth is trying to pull the object towards itself. This object also exerts a force, but that goes unnoticed because of the huge mass of the Earth. This we have seen in the beginning of the lesson itself. Now, whenever you are throwing an object in an upward direction, its motion is in the opposite direction of gravity. It's working against gravity, right? It's moving against gravity. And hence the acceleration is shown in the seen or shown in the opposite direction. When the object is going up, acceleration is in the upward direction. When the object is coming towards the surface of the Earth, acceleration is seen downwards, right? Acceleration you all know. Okay, now, so when the object is thrown up, it's always moving in the opposite direction of gravity, and hence the acceleration is also in the opposite direction. So what about its velocity? See, whenever the object is thrown up, it moves with a certain velocity. As it reaches a certain height, as it goes on moving in the upward direction, its velocity keeps decreasing. At one point it becomes zero and then it starts coming down. You all must have observed. You can now try this at home also. You just throw a ball in the upward direction. So what happens? The ball will move, but after a few seconds the ball will start coming down. When you look at the velocity of the ball when it is moving up, you will find the rate at which it began its movement when it was thrown, that will go on decreasing when it is moving in the upward direction. At one point it will become zero, and at that point onwards it will start coming towards the surface of the earth. So its velocity goes on decreasing and finally becomes zero at some height, after which the object begins to move vertically downwards under the effect of acceleration due to gravity, due to which its velocity goes on decreasing. So remember one point: whenever an object is thrown up, its velocity goes on decreasing, becomes zero at one point, and then it starts moving downwards, and at this time also its velocity keeps on decreasing. Okay, so this point you should remember, very very important, because this acceleration due to gravity keeps changing from place to place. Okay, so to understand this, how does the value of g change? You need to understand the shape of the earth. Suppose if someone asks you a question, what is the shape of the earth, what's the shape of the moon, please don't tell it's round. It's not at all round. We call the earth to be spherical in shape. Moon is also spherical in shape. We say, or we think, the earth is spherical in shape, but it is actually a spheroid. That means what? It's slightly larger in radius at the equator than at the poles. Pole means what? The top portion, right? You must have learned this in your geography. And equator means what? The side portions. The earth is normally assumed to be flat at the poles and bulged at the equator. Okay, so that's why we call it as a spheroid. Okay, its radius is slightly larger at the equator than at the poles. You look at the shape of the earth given in the pictures here. See, equator, the side portions of the earth, look at the radius. What is radius? Distance between the center to the circumference, or the outside, means the end point. So when you draw a radius from the center of the earth towards the pole and in the equator also, you will find the length of the equator being larger, means the radius of the equator being larger when compared to the poles. Okay, so this point you remember: the earth is said to be slightly flat at the poles and bulged at the equator, and the radius of the earth is larger at the equator than at its poles. That is why we say the earth is ellipsoid or spheroid. This is a new concept which you are learning now. Right? Never say moon is round, earth is round. No. Earth also you cannot call it spherical. You have to call it as spheroid. Why should you call it as a spheroid? Because the radius of the equator, that region on the earth, is larger when compared to the radius of the poles. Okay. So, based on the shape of the earth, you have a question given in your textbook. Amit buys few grams of gold at the poles as per the instruction of one of his friends. That means what? His friend, Amit's friend, must have asked him to buy some gold from the place where he is staying. He must be at the poles of the earth somewhere. He hands over the same when he meets him at the equator. So Amit was asked to buy some gold because at that time he was at the region where the poles of the earth is, the regions that are located near the poles. Okay, then his friend was telling that from the equator. So when he came to meet the friend in the region, actually it is in the equatorial site, when he came to meet him, he handed over the gold to him. So will the friend agree with the weight of the gold bought? Obviously gold is costlier. See, whenever we ask someone to buy the gold income, we'll obviously wait and see. Why? Because it's very precious, costly enough. So this means what? What's the question here? Will the friend agree with the weight of the gold bought? Answer would be no. The friend at the Equita will not agree with the weight of the gold bought at the polls. Why? What is the reason? That's what we'll be learning in the next session. Okay, till then, you know, one day only left now. So I want you all to read your textbook thoroughly. This question is there, but the relevant explanation is not given in your book. So to understand this only, you know, to talk about the value of G only, I spoke about the acceleration due to gravity of the object when it goes above the Earth's surface, when it is coming towards the Earth's surface. And then I was talking about the shape of the Earth, because those are all related to this question. So just keep reading your textbook, and this part, the next session, whatever I'm going to give you, I want you all to pay proper attention, because if you don't understand that part, then you cannot answer this question. Okay, so keep repeatedly studying your textbook, play the videos again and again, and try to absorb, means understand what is taught, solve the sums in C. Take care, have a good day. Bye.